poppin'? What's poppin'? What's pop? Tiger Lily Squad! What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's hey? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What's ha? What's poppin'? What's poppin'? What? If anybody is like a songwriter or like put beats together and you want to turn my what's poppin' into like an intro, I'm trying to get an intro to all my videos with the what's poppin' song, and like I guess yeah, hit me up, because I really want to put it in the beginning of my videos. Anyways, we are back in the car, sis. We ain't do a car video in donkey years, Dread. So I have borrowed my friend's car, and while I was sitting in here, I actually want to go to Starbucks. So for the month of August, I'm doing no red meat and no alcohol. I started on August 28th. Technically, I started on August 29th because I had a drink on the 28th. Right. So, I'm doing no red meat and no alcohol. So only fish and chicken and water for the most part, darlings. And so far so good. I mean, I've had little moments where I wanted like a drink, but I haven't really been craving like steak and hamburgers and stuff like I thought I would. So that's a good thing. But let me sit y'all down. Where can I hold y'all? So dark. Okay, I'm gonna go to Starbucks and then we'll talk. Okay? Hold on. Hold on, sis. Ooh. That is an ugly angle. Hey, y'all. So, I got back from Starbucks and I changed my clothes as well because I felt icky and sticky. This is a matcha ice cream tea if anybody is concerned. So what I wanted to talk to you guys about is like, so I've been on like this soul search kick for quite a while and this self-development spiel for a couple years now, and I've been talking to you guys about this, but I've never I have delved into like why certain things is going on. And I feel, to be honest, and I just want to talk to you guys, to be honest, the reason I think I sabotage myself when it comes to relationships, I think I have manifested bad relationships. Let me tell you why. So a lot of times, you know, the law of attraction is what you think is what you get. Your thoughts become your reality. So for a very long time, I used to just be negative, like negative Nancy. I would just sit down and just write in my journal, I cannot believe he did this to me again. Why can't I find love? I'm just not meant to be happy. Like, I would just spew out negative stuff all the time. Like, this is my manifestation journal, but this wasn't like a thing that I would normally go to. I would not normally grab some crystals, like some clear quartz, and just sit down and just meditate and just thank God for where he's brought me today and set my intentions for the day and for the month and for the year and set my intentions in this relationship and live in the moment of now instead of past or future. You know what I'm saying? I just would just write down, listen, why the heck do I keep getting abused by this? Like, why every relationship I'm in, abuse keeps coming? What about me is not fulfilling enough for a guy to pick me? Why can't I be chosen? It's almost like, why this? why that, why this, why that. And if I truly am going to talk to you guys about law of attraction and manifesting stuff, you manifest your life, I have to be honest with myself and just be like, yo, Shay, low key or maybe high key, you brought all this upon yourself in a way. Like, none of this I deserve. And I would also like to say, all of this stuff, these people are responsible for their own actions. With that being said, if I would have realized the law of attraction way back then and realized that my thoughts become my reality and realized to let my life go to God and let Him handle stuff instead of trying to figure things out on my own, or when is this going to come in, or why, or just questioning everything, a lot of things in my life would not happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I keep saying that I don't deserve love, I'm never going to get it. If I keep saying that I'm the most unlucky person in life, I will remain unlucky. It's just the way of the world. And I have a law of attraction story. So while I was away, I kept thinking about someone, and they had like a surgery coming up, and I was mad at them, and I'm like, I hope that their surgery gets postponed. Like, I want them to have it, but I just hope it gets postponed, because they get things given to them so easily, and it's time for them to face a little bit of setback, right? But I just, nothing bad, nothing evil, just was like, I just hope their surgery gets postponed. And I said what I said, I let it, you know, law of attraction, you say what you say, you let it go, and let God and the universe do what it is that you ask for. Don't keep harping on it. So I would say it like once a day, just sporadically. There was no reason. I just would say it. And then I went on with my life. So then, the day the person was supposed to get the surgery, they had reached out to me and stated that something had happened, and that nothing bad happened to them, but that basically, in a roundabout way, the surgery needed to be postponed. And while they said it to me, I was just like, oh, that's crazy, I feel bad. I forgot that I've been saying this, right? So when I got off the phone with them, I was just like, wait a minute. And it literally happened. Another example of this is the 17 second rule. So if you don't know about Abraham Hicks, you should do a little bit of research on him. I'm pretty sure a bunch of you guys have read the book The Secret, and then he talks about the 17 second rule. It takes 17 seconds for you to just envision what you want. Just quiet your mind. Don't second guess. Don't put any negative energy into it. Just 17 seconds of just sitting down and just quietly just thinking about your intention and what you want. Say I wanted a phone call. So I envisioned 17 seconds. I put the timer on and I said, I would like such and such to call me, because I haven't heard from them in a while. So I was like, I would like such and such to call me. And I just thought about that for 17 seconds, right? Once the 17 seconds ended, I added 51 seconds to it. I added 51 seconds to it because it's supposed to be a combined time. So you could do 17, 17, 17, 17, or 17 and 51. No matter what it is, I did 51, and I sat there and I just thought about how it would make me feel when this person would call. Thought of it in the now. Instead of saying I wish they would, I said they are going to. Wouldn't it be funny if they did? You know what I'm saying? I spoke it positively. The emotions attached to it, it made me feel happy, blah blah blah. I woke up, I said thank you universe for giving me what I manifested for, and so it is, and so it is, amen. Went living my life like it's golden. I was watching Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Never mind. I didn't even look at the time to see how long it took. But I feel like in I got a phone call and it was from this person. Mind you, I hadn't spoken to this person in a while. So there was no reason for them to just like call me because we speak on a regular basis. But we hadn't had a falling out. We just have not, I just haven't felt the need to reach out, and they haven't felt the need to reach out either. I say all of this to say that law of attraction really works. When they say you manifest your own life, you actually manifest your own life. You ask for what you want, but that doesn't say that you should not work towards it. You let the universe and God do bring you what you're asking for, but don't just sit on the couch and leave it be. You know what I mean? Like, I had to refocus my mind when it came to love and came to relationships and stuff like that, because for a very long time, I would look at other people's relationships and be so jealous, which is not a good thing. I'd be so jealous and so needy and yearning for it that any and anyone would just come into my life and it wouldn't stimulate me. It wouldn't be satisfying for me. It was just not for me. And it's because of what was I thinking? I was yearning for this so-called love. I was desperate for this so-called love. I was jealous to see everybody else. And now it's just like, yo, I'm pretty happy and content with myself. I love love and I would love to be in a relationship. I'm just not desperate for it. And I know what I deserve and what I want. And I have stipulations and standards for myself, and the right person will abide by it or will fit into that seamlessly without me having to continuously having these conversations. But anyways, I just wanted to talk to you guys about that and just saying maybe I'm at fault. Low-key for all the tragic romances that have displayed upon my life, darlings. Anyways, guys, if you enjoy videos like this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't already, please go to my website, www.essenceofshay.com, and sign up for the newsletter. Please and thank you. If you haven't already, also please go get yourself a Covet Oil, the Lavender Hair Spritz, and the LOC shirts. I have them now in a heather gray with white writing. It now has the Adinkra West African print for leadership and charisma and all that stuff imprinted right on the sleeve, and also the ES on the back, so you know it's from your girl, right? So, and then also, if you don't want to go to the website, they're like t-shirts under this box area thing. I'm going to add some socks and other things. Click you guys some and get you a shirt. Alright, Tiger Lilies, I will see you next video. See you later, Tiger Lilies. I love y'all so much. Oh my gosh. You guys are the wind beneath my wings.
Crash course. Let me hide the money in the dashboard. Max mad, could you lost the brick inside the Porsche? Goofy with the curb.